Hi friends, how are all of you? So, I thought I should speak to you again today. So, I already told you about stuff coming in. So, slowly and slowly we are receiving certain things, and then we will start with a more professional setup. So, that being said, today's video is actually about a little bit of updates. I thought while we are waiting for the stuff to arrive and while we are waiting for the professional setup to begin the work again, why not just start some right away? So, the kind of energies, so we'll start discussing the energies, you know, and then we'll go to a more professional way of discussing energies, which you will see shortly, like, you know, when you see uploads being done for general airtime. So the kind of energies that I'm feeling are that, you know, everybody was on their path. You know, somebody was close to union, somebody was doing inner work, they were midway, and some other people had just started inner work. So, everybody was on their different point, and everybody was very actively doing, you know, their work, their spiritual work, which was required for them to. You know, some people were in the energy where they were more fixated on the outcome, that because they wanted union they were doing the work, and there were some people who understood that they truly need to do the work despite the union or not, you know. So what I mean to say is that there were different kinds of people doing different kinds of stuff, but they were doing it, you know, they were actively doing something about the journey. Now with the changes in the world that all of you know about that happened during this particular year, you know, things, even if you wanted to focus on something particular in your life, you could not, because this is the bigger picture going on, you know, this is the bigger picture going on. So, and why this happened and how this affected the twin flame journey in all aspects is, it made twin flames realize that there is a bigger power than them that can actually control their movement or their actions. So what I mean by this is that many twin flames, they're coming to the realization even now, and some haven't even come to the realization now of this fact that I'm going to tell you. Let's say some twin flames were planning mobility towards each other, which means they were planning traveling towards each other. Not all twin flames live in the same city or the same state or the same country or the same continent. So they were probably planning, you know, I shouldn't say probably, like they had it in their back of their mind that they want to travel in the coming future, or you know, even to visit, even to like permanently travel, or you know, whatever might be the case. But then they could not take that step, you know, they could not take this that step normally, like because they were delaying it, or they were in double minds about it or something, and then this thing happened, you know, which we all are facing. Now this thing put a total ban on any kind of movement or travel or anything like that. So this is some other power which is actually hindering what you wanted to do. Till this time, till the pandemic came, nobody actually in real terms thought that there could be something which could not make them do something when they wanted to do it. Everybody has had a very, you know, good idea about free will and stuff like that. No, you know, this is what I want. But now twin flames have come to the realization, and like I said, they are still coming to the realization. Some divine masculines have still not come to the realization that life is short and they need to plan things, they need to do the things that they want to do, they need to come into final conclusions. But also there is another aspect that if they have not come to final conclusions, it is not time yet, you know. Divine timing, as we call it, it's in our own hands. The more we do the work on ourselves, the more closer we'll come to divine timing. Divine timing is not a set timing. Let's say you decide today to work on yourself wholeheartedly, your divine timing will also get preponed. But this divine timing, when it is predicted that this is your divine timing, let's say 2 years from now or 1 year from now or 6 months from now, that actually is true, because that is the amount of time it is going to take you to come to that level of understanding of the spirituality of this twin flame journey. Even if you decide, even if you use your free will and you decide that I'm going to do this in 10 days, you won't be able to do it. Every person is different. For some person, we can say that he or she will be able to do it in 1 year. For some other person, we know automatically when we read their energy that they'll be able to do it in 3 years. So you might do a tall claim one day in excitement, but still you will take the amount of time that your energy or your inner being wants to take. So that is divine timing, you know. The amount of time that you will take to do the work or the patterns or the blocks that are meant for you to remove on this twin flame journey. The blocks and patterns could be your own, or they could be patterns of your partner, which means they could be patterns of your divine masculine or divine feminine. Mostly it is the other way around. It is the divine feminine who does the work, and the divine masculine. Now, the divine masculine could be a female also, could be a male also. We talk about energy. We don't talk about actual genders, you know, actual physical genders. So it could be anything. But now the divine masculine and the divine feminine both have come to this realization, or the universe. One of the lessons coming out of the pandemic for the twin flames is that you cannot or you should not take time for granted, you know. With whatever the divine masculine did prior also, you know, made some really rash decisions or made some, you know, all that was described in my previous videos, what the divine masculine was doing, you know, which was not very healthy for the divine feminine. That was another pattern, another template. Now this new template, which I'm talking about here, this new template is that because of the pandemic, what has the twin flame journey, you know, been given to learn? So this is the thing that I'm talking about, the realization. What we have been given through this pandemic is the realization that you, there is something bigger than you, which can also stall your, you know, activity. So don't take it for granted when the periods that you had free, where there was nobody external stopping you and it was all internal, that you were stopping yourself. Now there's something external also which can stop you. Tomorrow there can be, I don't mean it in the literal way, but tomorrow there could be an earthquake, there could be some landslide between two countries, between two states, between two cities, and your mobility could be further restricted, you know. So anything, God or the universe can plan anything, and you should plan in the time in between, you know, a disaster. Now, this doesn't mean that disasters will keep striking, but this is one big lesson, you know. Sometimes we wait too long, sometimes we delay things too much, you know. The divine masculine kept himself on a hinge all the time. In all of my channelings, it was coming that he's keeping himself on a hinge, which means that he's neither on a yes, neither on a no. One day he's on a yes, one day he's on a no, and that is dragging for years, you know, together. That was dragging for years together, you know, and he was not making a decision. Had he made a decision that, okay, you know I have shadow aspects, who doesn't? Nobody is perfect. If he had made the decision that I know that, you know, I have shadow aspects and she has shadow aspects as well, so we can work on this together, but we need to be together first, you know. So union could still have happened, you know. Union is not that place where nothing bad will happen, you know. Union, after union also, you might have shadow aspects which both of you need to work on. But union is that point where both of you decide that we are there for each other, we are going to do this together, you know. And these are issues of intimacy, basically. Till you keep feeling that I cannot be totally raw and open in front of the other person, you keep shirking that connection. It could happen between friends also. Sometimes when we don't have good clothes to wear or something like that, we don't want to go out because what will our friend say? You know, what is she wearing or whatever. Those are also intimacy issues in a way, you know. So between these twin flames, why he could not decide at that time? He was ready. It wasn't like he didn't have the basic things in life to sustain a relationship, or she didn't have the basic things. what kept them away was fear of intimacy. That, you know, this is wrong with me, what if the other person sees? Because relationships are our true reflection, you know. They really show us the mirror, whether they are twin flame relationships, soulmate relationships, or even average. I don't believe there are any average relationships. If not a twin flame, the any person, your father, mother, friend, is a soulmate, you know. So those are our true mirrors. That is why we fear that intimacy, because we, let's say some of us have been single for so long, or some of us have you know, had bad relationships. So it is like a fear factor that, you know, this person will also judge me the same way. Although with twin flames, they are supposed to work together to reach their goals, you know, which would have been the case if this connection could have gone forward with the two of them, or the two of them would have decided at a point prior to these things happening in the world that we are going to work on this. So this is that kind of a lesson that God has given twin flames, or twin flames who are not ready to move before they reach perfection. Perfection can never be reached. Anything that you do, let's say you decide to do something today, you should always keep working on yourself. But let's say you decide to do something today, 2020 month of August, in 2021 month of August, you will be a new version of yourself, but there will be more work to do because time has also moved forward. So you're never going to reach perfection. The best way is to keep working on your patterns, to keep working on patterns which are priority first. And how you will know your patterns, you can only know through a reading or a list, you know, as far as I can tell you. Otherwise, if you can use your intuition and you can know your patterns, or by conversations with your twin flame, your masculine or your feminine, you have realized that there are certain patterns, let's say maternal healing or ancestral pattern or geographical pattern, you know, something that you have realized, then you can take direct inner work sessions from my website, you know. If you have not realized, you will obviously want to have the reading and then the inner work list. Besides the point, I don't want to talk about you know, what you need to buy. So you can never reach perfection. What you can do is you can start working on your bigger patterns first. Then you can start working on patterns which are little less priority. Then you also might need to work on patterns of your partner, because they are not moving, you know, or they are not ready to do it themselves, and why they are not ready to do it themselves, you shouldn't even bash them for that, because maybe they have not even realized that. Maybe that they know there are issues in their family, you know, or something is wrong in their family, but they don't know it is a family healing situation. You know, so it could be, if you want to give them the benefit of doubt, it could just be that they don't know about it, or they don't realize that that is the pattern, you know. They just think that, yeah, like with this example that I'm giving with family healing, they could just feel that, you know, dysfunctional families are the norm, you know. They could just feel that that is normal. They could not realize that, you know, things are needed, or they need to work on this or something like that. So you need to also work on the partner. So the main thing about this whole, you know, way that I'm trying to explain you is that time has been lost. That is the main thing. And because time has been lost, everybody has had to face a lot of issues. The divine masculine maybe has had to face issues that now people have started questioning him. And I'm not just saying this randomly, this is a channeling, you know. People have started questioning him regarding what is he going to do regarding his love life or his marriage or stuff, you know. People have now started questioning him. And with the divine feminines, they've gone through a lot more trouble. People have started questioning them also. People have started questioning, why are you like a burden on us? You know, why are you not getting married? You know, why are you delaying? Because some of the divine feminines have been on the journey for 5 to 7 to 10 years. And for 5 to 7 to 10 years in some culture, just sitting without marriage is not considered something healthy, you know, or people don't allow it, or the society doesn't allow it. So for those kind of people, it has been really hard, you know. And also they could not focus their energies on another man, you know, because obviously out of love, you know, out of love they are waiting. If the divine masculine thinks that they are waiting because they can't find anybody else, or they don't have a life, you know, it's not like that. he needs to come out of it. They are waiting because of love, if they are waiting. They are doing inner work because of love, if they are doing it. They are getting all these services out of love, you know, because they want to work on this relationship only, because they know in their intuition that this is the partner, this is the meant to be, this is the one. Had they known that this is not the one, this is just a soulmate, and you know, why would they waste so much energy, time and money on this connection, you know? So had the divine masculine awakened before and come in his imperfect self, because even the divine feminine is not perfect. She's just ahead of the divine masculine in terms of knowing about this connection, in terms of working on this connection. So otherwise also, if we see average or soulmate relationships, one partner is always, no two partners are at the same, you know, there's always one partner teaching the other partner something or the other, you know. It could be that one partner is a better cook and they teach the other partner how to cook. One partner is a better person to manage groceries or to go out and buy stuff for the house. So it can never be similar, because two people have been raised differently. Their upbringing is different. Their talents are different. The way they perceive life is different. And they come together to make a full whole. They have to complement each other. So one person is good at buying groceries, the other has to be good at cooking. If both are good at cooking and nobody wants to go out of the house, how is it going to work? So God always, or the universe always, creates things which are complementary. And to reach that complementary person, or to reach that complementary stage, you have to go through many lessons and experiences in life. Now those lessons or those experiences will actually mold you to actually be a complement of this person. When you start, maybe like in the beginning, your mother, you know, any guy or girl from any country, your mother, when you are a teenager, tells you, oh, you should know how to cook, you should know how to cook, you know. At that point, some people think that, you know, this is a gender issue and your mothers are telling you to cook because you are a female or because you are a male or something like that. But when you actually start adulting or start living an adult life, you realize that cooking is a life skill. It is not a gender issue. Cooking is a life skill which you should know, because if you want to survive, you have to eat, you know. So no one person can cook all the time. So nobody is actually perfect. In our imperfect state, if we start accepting each other, unions will be much preponed. If we decide today that, okay, we are going to prioritize our inner work, and whatever is required right now on priority, we are going to do it, we are going to get it done. And whatever is not required, maybe we can do it in 3 months or 6 months time. You know, there are priorities to inner work. Let's say if you're living in a pure family narcissistic situation, that is your priority. Or if your twin has had 6 or 7 partners in 1 year, a karmic pattern is his priority, which you need to indirectly get done, because he's involved in the situation. He's not even thinking objectively that he could get some spiritual work done to remove this karmic partnership or to prepone its destruction from his life, you know. So give the other person the benefit of doubt. It's like a thunderstorm is coming and one person got to know it before the rest of the town, and he's saying, why should I tell the town, because you know they should also know it. Why should I tell the town to save themselves? Because they should also know it. It's not my duty to tell them. It's like that. If you are thinking that, why me? Why me? Why am I supposed to do all the inner work? Then it is like you have been given this warning by the universe that this is the root cause, and you are saying that, why should I do this work, you know? Because possibly you are having you are going to spend that money or whatever the case is, you know. Don't think like that. Ultimately, if you're going to make a home with this person, then it is your mutual work. However hard or a bitter pill to swallow it, you have to swallow it right now. If you want to move ahead in this connection, you have to do the inner work. You have to do his inner work also, you know, whoever the divine masculine is, even if it is a female. So this is the case. This is what the situation is right now, that it is a regretful energy. it is an energy of having committed some foolishness. It is an energy of what now, because so much time has lapsed, you know, in many cases. These are all the divine masculine energies, you know, what he is feeling. So, you know, this could have easily been prevented, but it could have been prevented only if he knew all these things at that time, you know. Possibly even now he doesn't know it fully, you know, doesn't have the full realization. That is why unions are delayed. That is the thing, you know. Nothing happens from thin air, you know. Even spirituality is scientific. What outcome you will reach depends on what hard work you are doing. Spirituality is not like just making up things and manifesting. Manifestation also you will be able to do only when your energies are aligned, or when your attraction point is at that level, or at that point where you can attract that positive thing. And that will only happen when you are positive. When you have so much inner work to do, how can you be positive in your inner being or in your energy? You won't, because the inner work or the patterns or the templates are still in your body. They are there in your energy. So you can't be that. So law of attraction, if you're using to manifest your twin flame union, that also is interrelated to inner work, because inner work will actually clean your inner being. Clean your inner being, and it will clarify your vibration. Clarify it to a positive vibration. Only with a positive vibration you can start attracting a similar vibration. So if your vibration is not there, if you are just blindly sitting in your room and thinking that, okay, I don't need inner work, but I can just use the law of attraction, which some people are doing, it cannot happen. You will not be able to manifest, and then you will lose 1 year, and then you will think that what happened, you know. Maybe the law of attraction doesn't work, maybe this book secret doesn't work, you know. It is not working because inner work. That is why I keep saying inner work, inner work. Inner work has to be done for every twin flame couple, whether you like it or not, whether you have the money to spend on it or not. Whatever clause you might put, every clause is going to be, you know, like it has to be cancelled. Ultimately, even if you want to wait 3 years and hold that, you know. See, money, finances is just an exchange for what you get, you know. You have to think about it like this. If I'm wearing this shirt, I had to give, what, $12 to Forever 21 to get this. It is an exchange. If I want this, I have to give that money to get this, you know. So everything in life is an exchange, actually. There's nothing that is not an exchange. Think about it carefully. The food that we eat, the air that we breathe, you know. The air that we are breathing is actually, you think that is free of cost because that is given by God. But we are also moving according to God's plan. So that is what we are giving back. That we cannot form our own plan if you think that you can live your life according to your own plan. It is all destined by God already. So the air that we are breathing, the water that we are consuming is given to us by the universe. But what we are giving back to the universe, that we are, the universe is the driving force. The universe is the petrol. God is the petrol that is driving our cars every day. Driving our body, you know, which is a car every day. If God doesn't will for us to live for another second, we will die that very second. So that is what we are giving back. Everything is an energy exchange. Similarly with your twin flame also, everything is an energy exchange. The more purer your energy, the more positive your energy, the more cleaner your vibration, only then he will become cleaner and you will join with each other. When there is this vibration, your vibration, this is his vibration. If both of your vibrations have the surrounding thing around the vibration, which is unhealthy, let me use something. So this is the unhealthy stuff around the positive vibration, and then this is your vibration. You also have, just imagine a similar paper. So when you will, even though you do some inner work, when you will connect, there will still be this thing. You can't fully connect, you know. You can't fully connect. So this is the inner work that has to be done. So when you do inner work, all these negative vibrations come out, and then only technically union can happen. Because I keep saying union is very scientific. It won't happen till this is removed. Now this can be removed from any person that you trust, you know, who can do inner work, who can do twin flame specific inner work. As you all know, we have developed a new website and we have done everything for you. So you can choose us, you can choose anybody you like, you know. So that has to be that. You know, that you need to decide when and where. For me, if you want to take my advice, inner work is priority right now. It is priority, and specifically with the this lapse that everybody has got, it is a self-reflective mode in itself, the lockdown of the pandemic. It is a self-reflective mode, so if you get things done in this time, you know, maybe it will complement the already self-reflective energies that everybody is having. Because obviously when you're sitting idle, which most people, like, you know, have more time, not entirely idle, but most people have more time than usual, than they used to have. So obviously, like, you know, if you have more time than you used to have, obviously some thought is going to come into your mind. That is why the divine masculine is also reflecting and you are also reflecting. But right now you are unable to do anything, you know, unable to do anything, because there's an external force which doesn't want you to do anything. So at this point you can either feel that I don't even know the future, what the future is going to be, and you can keep sitting, or you can be very smart about it and you can finish all of your work in this time, you know. Now everybody has to do work on themselves. Nobody is a person who now doesn't need any kind of work. You know, everybody is doing it. Everybody is doing it. You, the person next to you, you know, in some way or the other, everybody is doing it. So inner work also is not some kind of a thing which comes, is an unnatural thing or something like that. You know, people who are not on the twin flame journey, they could also be doing some form of inner work, because they could be on a spiritual path or a spiritual journey. You know, not everybody is on a spiritual path, and not everybody is specifically a twin flame, but everybody is in under some form of awakening or not. Now also another point is, there are some people who probably this is their fifth lifetime, you know. And there are some people for whom this is their 30th lifetime. So obviously a person who's on their 30th lifetime will have more harder work to do. Because the person who, it's just the fifth lifetime, they are on a lesson where they have reached probably Z, probably J in A, B, C, D, E, F, you know. But a person who's had 30 lifetimes, they've probably come to maybe Q, you know, in learning in lifetime. So they are going to have harder and harder lessons, you know, harder and harder inner work. So you need to understand this also, and to know how many lifetimes you've lived, you can only know that through a past lifetime reading, which is also on the website, you know, if you go. So your twin flame could be like 5 lifetimes old, you know, and you could be 35 lifetimes old. So obviously there's a discrepancy in itself biologically. Biologically only there's a discrepancy, plus what he's doing in this lifetime. So how can you expect things to move forward, the dice to roll, without doing inner work? You cannot. And these are the energies that I've explained today, which are currently going on. So you need to decide based on this, which path you want to choose. Whether you want to choose this path, then you go on to inner work. If you don't want to choose this path, then you better start working on something else which you want to do in this life. Anyhow, your free will is not going to be sustainable, even if you decide that, if you're a true twin flame and you decide that I'm not going to be on this path, then also, like, maybe in 3 years or 4 years time, you will be brought again back to this path, you know. So I would urge you not to make that decision. If you are a true twin flame, you should work on this path or this journey, but ultimately the decision will be yours. My final advice to you is, if you know that you are a twin flame, you go ahead with the inner work with us. If you don't know that, if you are a twin flame, then you get the reading with us. You will know if you are or if you are not, and then you can proceed with the inner work. So this is all I wanted to say, you know. So as you know, we'll be making much more, you know, we'll be doing much more work in the coming days. So let's see, we do this with alignment, or I do this with alignment when I feel aligned, you know. Like right now, what the time is, it's around 8:40 in the evening, you know. So I was aligned and I had not planned this, you know. I don't plan my videos. So when I'm aligned, I will film. If I'm not aligned, I won't film. So this is how it goes. And I had no clue that I'm going to do it. It's kind of the end of the day, you know. So if it is a planned thing, people do it probably in the morning or the afternoon. But like I said, I do these things when I'm aligned to tell you something. You know, I could keep getting messages, but if I'm not aligned to sit in front of a filming apparatus, I won't do it. So alignment is very important in every aspect of life. So to come into alignment with this, or to come into alignment even with a piece of chocolate cake, you have to have a very positive vibration. Then the chocolate cake will come out of anywhere. You just do this experiment one day, and if you're not aligned, the chocolate cake won't come. You know, it can take 2 months. Even if you go to the bakery yourself, they will be out of chocolate cake. So vibration is very important, folks, in everything. So with that, let's be very cheerful, and please follow my advice. Thank you so much.